So that ties together this what constructing D does for you and connecting it to the hardest examples. So now that gets us to a nice little trick where we can talk about how we actually output our final example. So the way you construct your final example, the way you do that combination in the step is basically by doing a weighted average. And the weight is going to be based upon this alpha sub t. So the final hypothesis is just the SGN function of the weighted sum of all of the rules of thumb, all of the weak classifiers that you've been picking up over all of these time steps, where they're weighted by the alpha sub t's. And remember, the alpha sub t is 1/2 of the natural log of 1 minus epsilon t over epsilon t. That is to say, it's a measure of how well you're doing with respect to the underlying error. So you get more weight if you do well than if you do less well, where you get less weight. So what does this look like to you? Well, it's a weighted average based upon how well you're doing, or how well each of the individual hypotheses is doing. And then you pass it through a thresholding function, where if it's below zero, you say, you know what, negative. And if it's above zero, you say, you know what, positive. And if it's zero, then you just throw up your hands and return a zero. In other words, you return literally the sign of the number. So you are throwing away information there, and I'm not going to tell you what it is now, but when we go to the next lesson, it's going to turn out that that little bit of information you throw away is actually pretty important. But that's just a little bit of a teaser. We'll get back to that there. Okay, so this is boosting, Michael. There's really nothing else to it. You have a very simple algorithm, which can be written down in a couple of lines. The hardest parts are constructing the distribution, which I show you how to do over here, and then simply bringing everything together, which I show you how to do over here.
All right, yeah, I think it doesn't seem so bad, and I feel like I could code this up, but I would be a little happier if I had a handle on what why alpha is the way that it is.
Well, there's two answers. The first answer is you use natural logs because you're using exponentials, and that's always a cute thing to do. And, of course, you're using the error term as a way of measuring how good the hypothesis is. And the second answer is it's in the reading you were supposed to have done. So go back and read the paper now that you've listened to this, and you will have a much better understanding of what it's trying to tell you.
Thanks.
You're welcome. I'm about helping others, Michael. You know that.